Hey guys, it's Jillian here at Berkshire Yoga Dance and Fitness, and I'm super excited for you guys to join me for my barre fitness class today. I know there's going to be a lot of new faces out there, and my Sunday crew, I hope you can watch this, get your barre on. All you're going to need today, really don't need anything. You can grab a mat, use your carpet if you don't have a mat, 1 to 3 pound weights, which are optional for any of this stuff. You might be thinking, oh, that's nothing, that doesn't weigh a lot, I'm going to go grab my 8 pound weights. Don't do that, trust me. So weights, I'm also going to be using a loop band for when we go to do our mat work, and then my Pilates ball. If you don't have any of this stuff, no worries. Everything is adaptable. The equipment's just like a little extra something. And I just wanted to say real quick before we get started that barre gets a really bad rap. It comes off as very intimidating to a lot of people. So don't be afraid. It is challenging. It's low impact though, so you can control, really focus in on what your body can do. Okay, that's not for me. I can't do that many reps today. I need to take that modification. And that's the awesome part, is there's modifications for just about everything, which I'll call out. But yeah, don't be afraid. Everyone should try barre at least once. Might not be for you, and you might be addicted. It usually works either direction. So I'm really excited to get started today, and feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions afterward. So let me go turn my music on. We'll get warmed up. I think I said everything I need to say. You go grab that music. All right. So if you have a mat, you can go ahead and straddle the mat. Toes are turned out, so we're in our wide second position. We're gonna bring our arms nice and rounded, nice tall upper body, heads lifting like we have that invisible string lifting us up. Rounded arms in front of the shoulders, you can tuck in those thumbs, and we're just gonna plie down. So knees track over the toes, shoulders stay over the hips, we have a neutral spine. So we're not squatting back. Weights evenly distributed. Sliding down the wall. Let's dig in. Here we go. Little pliés, make sure you don't knock those knees out. On the way up. Keep it nice and tall. Your hands and glass keeping you upright. Neutral spine. We've got 4, 3, 2. Last one. Now take a big breath. Bring it back. Here we go. and dry ready. Stay with it. Four, three, two, last one. Shake it out. From here, we're gonna go to the mat. Tricep dip. So let me scooch myself out of the way. So I'll move my mat to the side so you can see me here. A little bit better. So you're gonna come down to the mat. Toes face forward. Hands come behind you, fingertips facing forward. If you need to modify, you have a hand or wrist injury, go ahead, stay here, work against your own body weight. Otherwise, we're gonna lift up, bridge position, 10 stacked, so heels are stacked, 10 demi point on the balls of our feet, and then we're gonna flatten the left side, right leg extension, then 10 on the left. Here we go, stack those heels. Take the modification if you need it. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Toes, feet. Demi point. If that's too much, keep them flat. Here we go. Another 10. I want you to make sure you're not just dipping your pelvis. Make sure you have the bend in the elbow as you lower down for 10. Eight. We also don't want to lock it out, right? Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Flatten those feet. Extend the right leg. Nice pointed toe. Really reaching through that leg. And that left foot is planted into the mat. Like you're a tree and you have roots. Nice and planted. Here we go. Ten. Nine. Eight. Individually wrapped chocolate, right? We stretch out through every muscle group, so it's like our little reward to keep us going. All right, we're gonna flip over. We're only gonna do a 30-second plank. My people in my Sunday class are probably like, hallelujah. So 30 seconds. Take my watch off so I can time it. You can do whatever variation you need. So you can go ahead, do straight arm, hands are underneath the shoulders, feet are about hip width. Tuck that pelvis under. We don't want any downward dog for this, right? Hold it here. You can be on your knees. Also four. 30 seconds. You ready? Here we go. Tuck my shirt in here so I don't lose it. 30 seconds on the clock. Just because I'm not there with you doesn't mean you're going to drop your knees, right? Keep it going. We got this. Find that focal point slightly in front of you. Abs are pulled in. Shoulders down away from the ear. 15 seconds. 10. 5. Drop it down. Slowly press that child pose. Get a little stretch. Biceps. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my weights. I've got about 2 pounds here. Grab a little sip of water. So now, make sure my head's not getting cut off here. So we're going to bring our heels and toes into touch. Shoulders down and back. Again, weight. You can skip the leg portion here. You can also skip the weight. So just remember that, or if it gets too much, put them down. No shame in that. Roll those shoulders down and back. too much, you can take a little plie and hold it here. That might be harder for you, who knows? But listen to your body. If it's too much, drop it down. Here we go. Keep breathing. Lift all the way up, lower down. You can also make these a mini elevator calf raise, only lifting up halfway. Four. Three. You're going to hold it at the top in two. Last one. Hold it up. Ten. Nine. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Drop it down. Now we're going to coordinate 90-degree curl with our calf raise. Lift. Up.
two, up, up, four, three, two, last one. From here, we can drop in 1 sec, come right back into it. Now from here, we're gonna go ahead and extend, reach, extend, reach. So extend to the sides and through, come back to goal pose. And again, if you need to put your weights down at any time, no shame. Stay with it. Four, three, two, last one, hold it out, up, up, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, last one, bring it back to goal post, last 7 shoulders here. From here, you're gonna flip it upside down and back. Nice and controlled. Stay strong. Things are working, right? Four more. We're going to shrug it up. Three, two. Last one. Hold it at the bottom. Shrug, shrug. Squeeze, squeeze. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Oh, drop those shoulders. Or drop those weights. Don't drop your shoulders. Stretch your shoulders. Arm across the chest. Stretch it out. Woo. Other side. Grab a sip of water here. I'm going to hit those triceps one more time. So we're going to come in a parallel position. Toes and heels are touching. Abs are pulled in. So you're just going to do a little hinge here. Small bend in the knee. Again, abs pulled in, shoulders back. Extend it back, little pulse. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, last one. Hold it to the top. Now we're going to go into a kickback position. Top part of the arm is not going to move. Elbow acts like a hinge, extend back. Start with my weight. You need to modify this PA. Instead of putting that belly point, keep those heels on the foot on the floor. Take your little PA here. Otherwise, straight legs, free lift. All the way up. Make sure that weight is towards the big toe and all the foot. And the ankles are rolling down. Or the heels are rolling down. If you find that happening, I want you to just drop the heels. Lift up. PA down about 2 inches.
Five, four.
Take a time to shake. Squeeze that foot.
Drop it, really take a little stretch.
So you're going to lift that leg, cross over one side of the supporting leg, make an arc with that big toe, other side. We've got 8, 7. So make sure that you're going to, I normally don't encourage you to look at your feet, but if you do a quick look, that toe should be on one side of the leg, make the arc, other side. 4, 3, strong leg. Last one. And bring it back, first position. Stretch. And then you can bring the other side. We'll do a little crossover here, both sides.
All right.
out back. So we'll say that you're just going to tap towards the floor and back. Six out of eight.
We're gonna start my right hand stack behind the head, hips are stacked. I'm gonna crunch
stay with it. Four. Three. Two. If it's too much with the crunch, you can hold it here too. Last one. Slowly drop it down. We're going to swing it over to that other side. Almost time to cool down. Last 10 here. Make it count. Forearm parallel to the mat. Hips are stacked. Nice alignment here. I'm going to bring my top leg up. Here we go. So hold it or crunch it in. Nine. Eight. Keep those hips stacked. Five. Or eight, I'm sorry. Seven. Side to side, reach towards that extended leg.